is true, and I owe it all to you.
Oh, I had the time of my life, and I never felt this way before. And I swear this is true, and I owe it all to you.
Dirty bit. Ah, there we go.
All right, welcome. Hello. Yeah. Oh my God. So crazy. If you don't know me, my name is Greg Delaney, and I teach. Yes, hi. And I teach in the Department of Architecture, and I am lucky enough to be the first to welcome you to our official 2021 Awards Day and Atelier. Yes. Awesome. So I will be serving as your MC for today, but we've got a lot lined up, and we're so excited to see all of you. This is, you know, obviously the last year and a half has been long and challenging, but we are just so happy to be able to end the year like this, all back together, even distanced and whatnot, but maybe more comfortable than ever. We've got couches, and you guys definitely win the award for best circle. But we're excited to be here in person and really celebrate the end of the year. I want to say a couple things before we get started. One, you guys should all have cowbells, yes? Okay, yes. Okay, so you're going to have to ring these cowbells, all right? So let's just practice that one more time, all right? Cowbells, all right, go. Cowbell. Yes. Okay. We're going to need a little more energy than that, so we need more cowbell. We got to really lay down the cowbell, you know? And then maybe some, like, screams and shouts and just general enthusiasm and just this is the best day of your whole year, okay? That kind of, yes, yes, all right. There we go! Yeah! Okay, that's pretty good, pretty good. So that's going to be when we, after we announce awards and we celebrate everyone, of course, that's our applause on the big field here. So, okay, a couple other things. We are live streaming the event too, so we've got a lot of people watching online. So let's all give them a hello. Hello, everyone at home in your pajamas. Welcome. Good. And a couple other things. So one, you do have to stay in your circles, all right? So when how this is just going to work logistically is when we announce awards for awardees, we will actually have some runners that will bring the awards to you. So when your award is announced, please just stand up and kind of give a big wave and a cowbell maybe, and we'll run out the awards to you as they're announced. So just stay in your circles. Another thing is that you do have to wear your mask still in your circle unless you're eating, okay? So because this is still an event, a large-scale event, the UB rule is that we still have to wear masks. But of course, if you're eating your lunch, you can take your mask off to eat your lunch. So, all right, so I think that is it as starting announcements go. Welcome, get excited. We've got Bob Shibley, who is, our Dean of the School of Architecture and Planning, and he is going to give you his welcome. Yes. Woo!
You know, in diving competition, you get points for complexity, right? You do a simple swan dive, that's so much, but if you do something fancier, you get more points. So you all have done something extraordinarily fancy this year. You've done an architecture and planning and real estate education in a pandemic. So you get lots of extra points. When they brought this, yeah, do that. Lots of points. Now, in a world with lots of points, it's also really important to recognize the colleagues and friends and family that brought us here and that gave us that kind of resilient character and helped us build a culture here at school that could succeed in the face of a pandemic. So ring your bell for that too. In the world of complexity, when Greg and the team came to me and said, we need to do an awards day, but we shouldn't set our expectations low, i.e. making do, we should knock it out of the park. So I want to welcome you to the largest ever Atelier and Awards Day ceremony. Congratulations. We have lots of food, cowbells, and awards and cowbells, and a few pyrotechnic cannons to play with today. So we're gonna have fun, And I think I'm going to turn it over to who's next, Greg?
Well, I'll think about
it. You got it. All right. Thank you all for coming. It's terrific to see you. And those of you at home, thank you there as well. We look forward to a great day.
Thank you so much, Bob Shibley. Yes. All right. I want to also just mention before we get started, so you guys are all in these circles. So a quick thanks also to the sophomores who actually planned the field for us and laid out all of the circles and painted them and figured out the balloons. This is all designed because we've got some drones. We'll see if this works out. But the blue and white actually lay out the interlocking UB in the field, yes. So we don't know if it'll be legible or not, but this is the test. So pretty cool. So thanks to the sophomores too. So give it up to them for helping us plan today. All right. So next, you know, we always start the day with not actual awards, but prizes. And since we've got a little bit of a different format this time around, we've got Dan Verana, who usually, there's Dan. Dan Verana, who usually, you know, pops the little tiny confetti poppers in the front of the room in Hayes 403 for every awardee. So instead, we really kind of, you know, pumped up the scale this year, and instead of prizes, we've got a T-shirt cannon. Yes. This is happening. This has sort of been Lindsay Romano's and my fantasy from, I don't know, for a decade now, that we would someday purchase a T-shirt cannon and have it for the school. So this was the perfect excuse. There we go! I know. Whoever's circle is closest, I guess, huh? You did it! Yes! Yes! So, let's see, open it up. Hold up the T-shirt. We've got T-shirts for everyone, and then also Lindsay Romano is gonna pop back over to you, and there's also a Amazon gift card for you, so get excited. There we go. Stand up. Show everyone your T-shirt. Show it off. Yeah. It is a School of Architecture and Planning T-shirt. Very cool, UB. Go Bulls. Okay. All right, we've got our first awards for the afternoon. So we have our Bachelor of Arts and Environmental Design Award. So for that, we've got Daniel Hess and Kelly Gregg, who will be reading off the awardees in the Environmental Design Program. All right, take it away.
You can keep that mic.
Okay. Hi, everyone. Welcome. So the first award in the Bachelor of Arts in Environmental Design is for excellence in academic excellence. This is in recognition of the highest overall GPA to a returning student in the BAD program. And the award goes to Eller Hitu. Raise your hand if you're here. Oh, there she is. Congratulations. Woo! I think that's a very special accomplishment in this year, especially. So well done. All right, so we have a virtual attendee. This is for the Academic Excellence Award, and this is the recognition of the highest overall GPA for a graduating student. And this goes to Omar Abraham. Congratulations, Omar. He has a 4.0, so that's quite an accomplishment. Hi, Omar. All right, now we have the Design Excellence Award in Studio for the Bachelor of Environmental Design. And this is in recognition of a BAD student who exemplifies consistent excellence in academic performance in the studio. And this goes to Tyson Morton, and he's joining us virtually today. Congratulations, Tyson. This is a great accomplishment again. And that concludes the Bachelor Environmental Design Awards. Where is Greg?
I'm here. All right, thank you, Kelly and Dan. There we go, give it up for all the BAED award winners. Yes, clap emoji. It's happening. Next, we've got the Bachelor of Science in Architecture Awards, and for that, we have Nicholas Rakovich.
Come on, guys, you can do better than that. Let's get this party started. So just to, so everybody knows here, when I agreed to read awards today, no one told me that I was going to have to wear tie-dye. So nobody looks good in tie-dye. So the Hyatt's Design Award is given in recognition of freshman students in the Department of Architecture with excellent design projects and a strong studio work ethic. We'd like to recognize the following students with the Hyatt's Design Award. So Kulongo Barkasbadi, you here? So, Jessica Chan, are you here? Where are you?
There she is.
She's in the back. Mark Chen. Where's Mark? Mark's right there. Jasmine Ferreras. A little bit of a mix-up here. Nick Francescos. Where's Nick at? He's over here. Joseph Glatz. I feel like after everybody rings their cowbell, just the person who won the award should ring their cowbell so we can find them.
This is actually our new faculty exercise program today.
What?
This is our new faculty exercise program.
Yeah, that's right.
Get us moving.
I should be the one running. So, Caitlin Glynn. Right here. Riley Golagi. Riley. Everybody's pointing in these different... Riley's over there. Alex Hoover. There's Alex, all right. Complete pandemonium. Zachary Izzo. I just love the fact that like all the administration is doing all the running. It's great.
Where's that? Oh, he's down there, I hear. There he is.
All right.
Black hoodie.
Alec Lewis. Aaliyah Tramp.
We might have missed one.
Is she here?
Nick, there was also, did we get this one? Jamie Jung?
Sorry. Jamie Jung.
Where is she? Jamie, where are you?
Jamie! Is Jamie here? Oh, over there. I see pointing. Yes.
I love the fact that all of the freshmen sat as far away as possible for the beginning of this, just to tire
Everyone
the faculty
did,
out.
Well, yeah.
I'm loving this job right now. So, Aaliyah, and how about Cheryl Q? There's Cheryl.
There she is.
Thank you for the energy, Cheryl.
You did it.
Patrick Schurer. Catherine Z. Carol Thomas. Where's Carol? Corey's gonna be so tired. Faith Bale.
100.
Katarina Voss. And last but certainly not least, Megan Wysocki.
Yes. So I should also add that we do have a guest here today. So we've got Greg Hyatt in the back here. Greg, give us a wave. So I'll just say quickly, the Hyatts are such a just amazing team and family and so supportive of the school. So all of these awards are gifts from directly from them. And so we're just so happy to have them as part of our UB family. And we're just happy they could also join us today. So thanks to Greg Hyatt. Yes! And congrats to all the Hyatts.
All right, it's time for a dad joke. So we all have to thank Lindsay, I think, for making us wear tie-dye shirts. There aren't many people these days that know how to make tie-dye shirts. You can say that it might be a dying art.
Pretty good, yeah. Cowbell.
So the Bachelor of Science in Architecture Academic Excellence Award is given in recognition of the highest overall GPA of a student in their respective year. We'd like to recognize the following students with the Academic Excellence Award. So with an overall GPA of 4.0, I'd like to recognize Kulongo Barkaspati. Yep. With an overall GPA of 3.99 in the second year, I'd like to recognize Katie Nelson.
Who was the faculty member responsible for that?
So with an overall GPA of 3.91, I'd like to recognize in the junior year, An Doe. And finally, for a graduating senior with a GPA of 3.77, Andrew Griffin. Oh, yeah, you need that. Andrew, where are you? Yeah, he's right there. Thanks. All right. So one of the only good things that's come out of the pandemic this year is that what I'm wearing now can be considered business casual. So the Bachelor of Science in Architecture Design Excellence Award is given in recognition of outstanding work in the Department of Architecture. We'd like to recognize the following students with the Design Excellence Award. Anana Khan. Where is she? And Joe or Hannah Ruth. Where are you at? So, in recognition of outstanding studio work at the second or sophomore year level, Katya Dorkorova. And also, in the second year level, someone with my most favorite name, Cole Wishman. Cole, where are you? My son's name is also Cole. He's over there. He's not winning any awards today. He got a cowbell. That's like an award when you're four. So in recognition of outstanding work, studio work at the junior level, An Doe. Where are you? And for graduating seniors, these two should have formed a rock band, Isa and Rocco. They're like the Hall of Notes of our architecture department. Sorry, I probably dated myself there. The faculty got it.
All right, let's give it up for Nick Ragovich and the Bachelor of Science in Architecture Award winners, 2021. All right, I think it's time for the T-shirt cannon. Dan Verona, where are you? Yes, there it goes. Yes. Again. Yeah! This is... don't get hurt by the... close range. All right, yes! T-shirt cannon! I'd like to say this is one of Nick Bruce's favorite gifts, so we like to use it. All right, we've got... All right, Master of Urban Planning Awards. We've got Dan Hess and Kelly Gregg.
I'm afraid of getting hit by a T-shirt, so I have to watch out in all directions. It's great to see everybody. So I'm happy to be here for the MUP Awards. The first award is the Academic Excellence Award in the MUP program. This is for the highest GPA for a returning student. And we have a three-way tie, with three students with a 4.0 GPA. They are Justin Belito, he's not here today. Hello, Justin, wherever you're watching virtually from. Next is Nathaniel Mitch. And finally, for the Academic Excellence Award, Ruth Fatalitis. Okay. Ruth, are you here? No, Ruth. Oh, wait.
Oh, is that her? There she is.
Okay, congratulations right to corner, those high yeah. GPA winners. Next, we have the Academic Excellence Award for a graduating MUP student. So this is in recognition of the highest overall GPA in the MUP program. And here go the bells, so we can hear the name Ian Stern with a GPA of 3.95. Ian. Okay, so next we have the MUP Award for Excellence in Studio. This goes to outstanding work in the MUP program in studios. And we have a tie. The first winner is Alexis Kennedy. She's not here today. She's joining us virtually. The second winner is Eric Wojcicki. He's not here today either. Next, we have the MUP Service Award. This is in recognition of a student who exemplifies a high standard of public service to the community. The award goes to Brennan Thompson. Brennan's not here today. The next award is the MUP Service Award. And this goes to the MUP student who exemplifies outstanding service to the school and department. And the winner is Daniela Leon.
Oh, she's over there somewhere. There she is. Yeah.
So now is the MUP Planning Chairs Award. So this is in recognition of the MUP student who exemplifies the best traditions of professional responsibility and academic promise. And the winner is Rakshanda Nagaraj, who's not here today. Okay, so now we have the Michael Krasner Memorial Scholarship. This is awarded by the Western New York chapter of the American Planning Association, and it's to the MUP student who shows a planning excellence and a commitment to professional practice in Western New York. And this award comes with a scholarship from the APA. And the winner is Annalise Paulson. Okay, and now we have the MUP Best Thesis Award, going to the highest quality master's thesis in the Department of Urban and Regional Planning, and the winner is Michaela Lippmann. Next, do we have her?
Do we have Michaela Lippmann?
Okay, we will get her that award. The AICP Planning Excellence Award. This is in recognition of high standard of professional and school citizenship. And the winner is Lanika Sanders.
Oh, yeah. So next we have our awards in the Master of Science in Real Estate Development Program. Give it up for RED.
Okay, so I'm sticking around for the Real Estate Development Awards. The first is the Academic Excellence Award in the MSRED program, going to the student with the highest overall GPA for a returning student. And the winner with a GPA of 3.98 is Dino Koutsandreas. He's not here today. Next is the highest overall GPA for a graduating student in the MSRED program. And with a GPA of 3.92, the winner is Jay Schwarzkopf. Okay, so we have the MSRED Studio Excellence Award going to the student who is showing outstanding studio work. And the winner is Emily Clotier. She's not here today. Okay, so now we have the MSRED Student Excellence Award. This goes to the highest standard of professional responsibility and academic promise for a graduating RED student. And the winner is Jay Schwarzkopf.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, in the MSRED program, this is the Public Service Award, going to a student who exemplifies a high standard of public service to the community. And the winner is Pamela Jackson. Okay, continuing in the MSRED program. This is the Service Award, and this is the student who exemplifies outstanding service to the school and department, and the winner is Mathea Mizzola. Okay, and in the Historic Preservation Program, we have an award for the student who exemplifies a high standard of professional responsibility and academic promise in historic preservation, and the winner is Libertad Figueroa. She's not here today, but congratulations to her.
All right, give it up for Dan and Kelly and all the Real Estate Development and Historic Preservation. Okay, there we go. Next, we've got our Master of Architecture Awards. Where's Nick Rakovich?
All right.
Do we have more dad jokes?
Oh, of course.
That's what I thought.
Thanks, Greg.
You know,
Lindsay, where's Lindsay at? I chose to wear these coveralls today so that I covered most of this tie-dye shirt. So. Nobody looks good. I mean, I love the feeling, but yeah.
I have to say, you know, I went to Old Navy the other day, and I know that's a really hip store you guys shop at, but it was
full
of tie-dye.
This is all ad-lib, by the way.
I know. This
isn't scripted. We're off script.
It was full of tie-dye. Just saying.
Yeah. I feel like I'm at a Fish concert in the 1990s, so. So the Master of Architecture Academic Excellence Award is given in recognition of the highest overall GPA of a student in the first 2 years of the 3.5-year MArch program in the Department of Architecture. We have a two-way tie. Each of the students have a 4.0 GPA. John Mark Silbert, who's not here today. And Nicole Sarmiento, who I think is here. Nicole, where are you? Nicole? Ring your bell if you're here, Nicole. Where? Right here. Hiding behind the tree.
Oh, no. There, I was like, where are you?
So now I'm gonna read the names of the students who are receiving the Master of Architecture Design Excellence Award. The first award is given recognition of outstanding studio work in the first year of the 3.5-year Master of Architecture program in the Department of Architecture. And this award also goes to John Mark Silbert. Second award is given in recognition of outstanding studio work in the second year of the 3.5-year MArch program in the Department of Architecture. It also goes to Nicole Sarmiento. The next Design Excellence Award is given in recognition of outstanding studio work in the MArch Ecological Practices Graduate Research Group. I'm happy to say, and we should all liken this for her, Heather Leslie. That was a dad joke, by the way. Her thesis was about lichen.
Not here.
Wow, I got hecklers. Awesome. Next Design Excellence Award is given in recognition for outstanding studio work for the Inclusive Design Graduate Research Group. This award goes to Sarah Lengeal.
Right, can you just give it to her?
Oh, there you are.
The next Design Award is given in recognition of outstanding studio work to a Master of Architecture Material Culture Graduate Research Group student. This award goes to Connor Harrigan. I don't think Connor is here today. Congratulations. Next award is for outstanding studio work in the Master of Architecture Situated Technologies Graduate Research Group. This award goes to Josh Barzada. Josh, where are you? Finally, the last Design Excellence Award, certainly not least, is given in recognition of outstanding studio work to someone in the Urban Design Graduate Research Group. The student yesterday, or Wednesday, proposed to cut Tesla building in half, Reed Hetzel. Let's give it up for all of the Design Excellence Awards. I know, I'm making it look easy. This next award is Sous Chef, thanks. The next award is the Chair's Award. I believe because I'm giving this award out, I am now Chair of the Department of Architecture, so. It's like the Iron Throne in Game of Thrones. We're gonna have a bloodbath later. In recognition of consistent, high caliber work in design studios performed over their time in the school, this award goes to Bree Mancini.
Bree, where are you? There she is, straight out. So the Alpha Rho Chi Medal is given in recognition of professionalism in leadership, service, and merit. And we're happy to say that this award goes to Rosanna Valencia. I don't believe she's here. Yep. Got quiet. So finally, last and certainly but not least, the AIA Henry Adams Gold Medal is given awarded to the highest ranking Master of Architecture students in recognition of excellence in architecture, leadership, and high professional standards. And we don't know if she's here today, but happy to give this award to Morgan Mansfield.
Oh, there she is.
Yay, Morgan!
All right, let's give it up for Rakovich and all the Master of Architecture Award. T-shirt cannon! Scream, get loud, come on. You're so excited, you're so happy. It's the best day ever. Yes, yes, there's one, I see it. There's an Amazon gift card with that. There we go. Oh my God, this is so amazing. Yes, Dan Brada. All right. Okay, so we're gonna take a minute here. We're gonna rewind to 2020. I know, everyone's favorite year. Let's see. Yeah, something like that. But 2020, you know, of course, we're so happy to be all together. At least I'll speak for myself and all of us faculty, and we know from hearing from so many students too, of being in person here today. But there is an event that we were unfortunately not able to be in person last spring, which was, of course, commencement of 2020. And so we have a lot of graduates here, and we wanted to take a moment just to celebrate all of them and kind of give them their big moment, at least, you know, a little bit retroactively here. But since it's the first time we've seen you all in person since graduation, we want to celebrate you. So if we could have all of the 2020 grads stand up, anyone who graduated in the spring or summer of 2020, there we go. Yes. We should have, it's all the red balloons. So red balloons are for our 2020 grads. You did it! You did it! And you're all still here in school. So we also then have a little something. So all of our faculty and staff, it looks like, are taking their positions now. So we've got a perimeter, we're building out a perimeter. And we've got some pyrotechnics here. So what's gonna happen is I'm gonna flip the slide and there's gonna be a cap from five, okay? So the slides are timed, so you'll just read out loud. Everyone should count down with the slides and be ringing their cowbells, all right? And screaming and doing all the things. One, then we will all, yes, do the thing. Launch a bunch of confetti in the air, all right? Let's do it! 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Yes. Congratulations to all of our 2020 grads. There's one late one, just like a real fireworks show. Awesome. Okay. Charlie Wingfelder, where's Charlie? Come on up, Charlie. Let's welcome Charlie up to the front. So Charlie is our current Brunkow Fellow and overseeing InterSight 23. And he's going to tell us a little bit about what to expect with InterSight this year and what InterSight is.
Hi, thanks, Greg. This is just a really quick announcement that InterSight 23, our journal of student work, is in the process of being printed as we speak. And these are some of the images featured in the book. We're really grateful for all of the students who submitted their work and many of you who took the time to talk with us about possibly the strangest, most difficult year in recent history. So if anyone's looking for some catharsis or an opportunity to celebrate our resilience, keep an eye out this coming week for posts and emails about the book launch. We're really excited to share this work with everyone. Physical books will be coming in packets for commencement, and the digital edition should be available the same day. That's it. Thank you, guys.
Thank you, Charlie. So yeah, keep your eyes out. InterSight is an amazing tradition of the school. We're on our 23rd issue, and so just again, a chance to really celebrate and share all of the amazing work that you guys do year after year. So thanks to Charlie for all his hard work. All right, yes, Charlie. We're not done. We've got more awards to give. So let's have Bob Shibley back up here. Welcome, Bob. Cowbell, more cowbell.
Thank you. So we get a bit scholarly at this moment. We say every year on awards day, we induct the next class of architecture students into Tau Sigma Delta. This society is an architecture and allied arts honor society, the only national honor society for architecture and design majors, accredited by the Association of College Honor Societies. Recognizing that we believe planning and architecture are all about designing and making the world and the policies that support it, we include our planners and architects and real estate development students in this mix. The society recognizes intellectual achievement, effort and initiative, as well as leadership and character. It's a prize of membership that acknowledges undergraduates, graduate students who attain high scholastic standing in their field. This is the top 20% of the class, and you take this honor society with you for the rest of your life. So we're gonna have 41 inductees read off in 41 seconds. Ready? Go.
Yes. So I'm going to do this. I did rehearse, but I'm sure this will be a disaster. But here we go. When you hear your name or see your name on the screen, go ahead and stand up, and we will have a big round of applause for all of our Tau Sigma Delta inductees at the end. Okay. So we've got da-da-da. Mario Aguilar, Oluwani Malola Bancone, Justin Bolito, Lindsay Brusso, Blaine Burnside, Andrew Callard, Aaron Codlin, Gina Gaudioso, Hannah Gee, Allison Gomez, Bethany Greenaway, Andrew Griffin, Andrea Harder, Connor Harrigan, John Henning, Reed Hetzel, Omar Ibrahim, Clifford Imes, David Kelly, Marietta Caberly, Catherine Mahoney, Brianna Mancini, Soha Mehta, Mitch Messi, Anna Mictul, Yoshi Fumioka, Anthony Pineda, David Pulliam, Madeline Rohrbacher, Lenika Sanders, Jasraj Sandhu, Jay Schwartzkopf, Craig Spengler, Ian Stern, Christopher Sweeney, Daniel Ukiri, Charles Wingfelder, Austin Wiles, Cameron Ziegler. There we go, Tau Sigma Delta! Congratulations! Rocky started, I think I missed one in there, but.
Well done, Greg.
Congrats.
Well done. The next award we're going to speak to is the Dean's Certificate. I'm now pleased to present that certificate. It's an honor that recognizes the highest academic achievement of a graduating student in the School of Architecture and Planning. This year's Dean's Certificate goes to Brianna Riley. Brenna is not with us today, but is in the ether, I think. So congratulations, Brenna. Brenna is a dual degree MArch MUP student with an advanced certificate in historic preservation. She embodies a recognition that architecture, planning, real estate development belong in the same sentence. Every year we announce the winner of the Fred Wallace Brunkow Fellowship.
the Department of Architecture's most prestigious honor. It's presented to a graduate architecture student in recognition of academic and creative excellence and superior character. The Brunkow Fellow, as many of you know, assumes the Herculean task and great honor of curating and producing our annual Journal of Student Work, Intersight. I'm pleased to present the 2021-22 Brunkow Fellowship, and by the way, this comes with money. Caitlin Brote. Unfortunately, Caitlin also is not here.
Yeah, Caitlin!
But yay, Caitlin. We honor her also through the ether. Congratulations. That finishes my bit for the day. Thank you.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Bob. Okay, if we can get David Kelly to come on up. We have a couple more awards. David Kelly, where are you? There you are.
David. Thank you. All right, hello everyone. So my name is David Kelly and I'm the president of the GPSA. And next to me is Daniela Leon, the vice president of the GPSA. And on behalf of the 2020-2021 Graduate Planning Student Association, we are excited to present the 5th Annual Outstanding Faculty Award. This award honors a graduate planning faculty member that exhibits exemplary qualities in teaching, research, mentoring, community engagement, and university service that planning students appreciate and value. We are excited to continue this tradition of recognizing a professor who has made an impact on our education and inspired us as planners and individuals.
Our recipient has been described as caring, passionate, and empathetic. Encouraging inclusivity, engagement, and enthusiasm, this individual facilitates intellectually stimulating and rewarding classroom discussions and has served as both a counselor and a mentor. They exude a memorable teaching style, genuinely care about their students, and challenge them to achieve their highest potential, especially in studio courses. Please join us in congratulating the Department of Urban and Regional Planning's 2021 recipient of the Outstanding Faculty Award, Dr. Emmanuel Frimpong Boama. Woo!
Now the students get to run to, yes. Oh, congrats, Emmanuel. All right, and next we have Jenna Herbert and Courtney Vona to present the Gary Day Award.
Thank you, sir. Hi, everyone. I'm Jenna Herbert, president of GSA, and this is Courtney Vona. She's the treasurer of GSA. And we are super excited to present this next award.
The Gary Day Award is an annual award presented by the graduate students to the Department of Architecture to an outstanding professor in the department. The Gary Day Award, originally created in honor of past Buffalo architecture professor Gary Day, is given to an individual who embodies remarkable dedication, leadership, and sincere devotion to their students in and out of the academic realm.
This year, the graduate students have chosen a member of the faculty that works to navigate the ever-changing digital process of fabrication and share their knowledge to inspire and encourage students. Always looking to expand the field of architecture, they advise numerous directed research and thesis students who are eager to learn under this recipient.
Not only are they an excellent educator, but they also show kindness and compassion to their students in all aspects of life. As a professor, this recipient understands that your best work comes from a healthy working environment, pushing students' design boundaries while maintaining a high morale in studio settings. It is our pleasure to award the 2021 Gary Day Award to Nicholas Brucia.
As one of your former students said, thanks for being a great homie.
Great.
Yeah, Nick! All right. Okay, and next we've got Beth Tauke coming on up. So please welcome Beth Tauke to the stage, or the front of the field.
Okay. Hi, everybody. Can you hear me?
Hi, Beth.
Hi. We finally got sun. Thank God. It's getting chilly out here. So do I have a script? Okay, I guess I am announcing the first ever recipient of the Tauke Lamar Scholarship, and that scholarship is a scholarship that has been given by alumni of the Department of Architecture, and those alums really wanted to make sure that they were giving money to support a student who had compassion for learning and a kind of an intellectual sensibility that was grounded in social justice. And so, without further ado, we would like to present the first of those scholarships this year to Patrine Thomas. Is Patrine here?
Patrine!
Where are you? Are you here?
Back there!
Congratulations!
Congratulations, Patrine! I'll also just add, we're so excited to have this scholarship in the name of Beth Tauke and Jean LaMarche, who have just been really the soul of the school for so long, so many decades now. And so it's been a big collective effort to get this scholarship going, and we couldn't be more excited for this first inaugural year. So thanks to Beth and Jean for everything. Beth and Jean. And congratulations to Patrine. So with that, well, now we actually missed, you might have noticed, we missed a t-shirt cannon round in there. So I think we should just go ahead and do it real quick. Does that sound good? There we go. Get loud. T-shirts are coming. You want one. You really want one. Dan, give the people what they want. That's what they want. Yeah. And then no one grabs it. Yes. All right. So back up at the front is Bob Shibley. Oh, one more surprise. All right, Bob.
All right. I think my mic is dying.
Oh, take this one.
So, folks, thank you for being part of this program. We now invite you to explore Atelier, which is installations and student work that are on display on the grounds and surrounding. I got to change a page. They're all over Hayes Hall and throughout the studio spaces in Hayes and Crosby. The exhibition map provided to you at the start of our program will guide you through that exhibit. So take this tour safely with your masks on at all times and keep within 6 foot of spatial distancing. We're almost done with this, but we're not done. For our remote guests, options for viewing the work online will be made available. A link will be shared via email in the next week, so look for us on the web. As you walk through Hayes Hall, you'll notice an inventive installation of wooden benches integrated with our HVAC units on the second and third floor landings. These benches are the result of a design competition launched about 2 years ago to address the design problems of students sitting on the HVAC units in the newly renovated Hayes Hall. Ultimately, transformable shells, originally designed by Joanne Seng, Seng Zhao, and Ying Ting Chen, under the direction of architecture adjunct faculty member Sarah Hyacy. This project was selected for development, and then UB Associate Professor of Architecture Jin Young Song and adjunct faculty member John Spillman led a seminar to develop the construction documents and drawings for the submission to the university. leading the fabrication of the units was our sophomore architecture students who built the entire project in the fabrication workshop. I hate it. This part. There's a page. Thank you. So, take a seat on the second floor of Hayes Hall. It's another one of those examples of permanent installation that add value to the life of our students and faculty and staff. Before we part ways, I'd like to acknowledge the phenomenal effort of our Awards Day and Atelier Organizing Committee, which began planning the event before the semester even began. They set a high bar for themselves and I think have done excellent work. They pulled out all the stops, folks, and thanks to their vision, creativity, leadership, and persistence, and superb planning, we've had the privilege of enjoying one of the most spirited and impressive Awards Day programs in the history of our school. Give you all a round of applause, everyone. You know, we do awards, we celebrate top performers, but we recognize that all of this is team sport. Everyone succeeding through these last years deserves recognition. Take a bow. All of you made these awards possible. Thank you. So very specific thanks go to the team that helped curate today. They go to Corey Don Smith, our chair in architecture, Lindsay Romano, director of the Fabrication Lab, Greg Delaney, clinical assistant professor of architecture, and a special acknowledgement goes to UB's Department of Environmental Health and Safety, they had to say yes, UB's Office of Special Events, and the Erie County Department of Health for their planning and problem solving. You have no idea the bureaucracy that went into making this happen. It was extraordinary work. And we have one special gift yet to be given. I'm going to ask Corey Don to manage that for us.
Come on! Let's go! All right, we have one last gift of major recognition for enormous effort, not only for today, but all year in allowing us to occupy the shop facilities. Lindsay, come forward. Biggest bell ringing yet, come on.
Yeah, Lindsay.
Master organizer, thank you so much for all you've done for all of us and the students this year. All right, Greg, over to you.
All right, so that is our Awards Day program. Of course, we've got one last t-shirt cannon round. Dan Brana, where are you? There we go, yes! Noise, make noise, get excited. Yes, yeah, there it is. With Hayes as a backdrop. Dan Brana, yes. All right, so that wraps up Awards Day at Atelier 2021. We're so excited that you guys all made it out here today. We're excited that the weather held out, that we had a little bit of sun, even though the ground has been a bit wet. But hopefully you guys had some fun today. And just congratulations to a really amazing year in terms of work and everything that you guys have all accomplished as students, despite all of the challenges. We couldn't be happier to see all of you guys today, so thank you, and have fun, stick around. We've got food if you didn't get a lunch. Atelier, there's all these exhibits through Hayes, Crosby, and outside from various studios and other classes. Thank you. And FYI, the confession.